I'm Sue. I'm just relating a story. It's all to do with what we've been through over the past few years. We started with a business. Unfortunately, we lost the business. And recently, we've also lost our house, which with me, it didn't affect me too much. But with Steve, with all the problems that we've had over the, not just the 2 years, but previous years, it all became too much for him.
As Sue just said, we've been through a very, very bad time. It did affect me mentally and physically as well. I did try to commit suicide on three attempts. First one was I was in intensive care for 3 days. The second one, I was sectioned. And the third one, I'd like riding a push bike. So the bike myself, we went for a nice ride, and I thought, right, I'm going to have my last drink on this planet. And I was going to jump off a bridge at the bridge inn at Shortwood. And there I met a lovely chap. And he said, this is no way to go. And he was there, he was put there at the right time, at the right place. His name was Andy McNeil. He is the verger at Christchurch Downend. And from that day on, I've had the calling of God. And I've never, ever looked back. Prior to that, I was a very, very selfish, horrible person, nasty person to be with. How Sue has put up with me for such a long time, I should never know. But since that day, the calling of God, I changed dramatically. And I just love living the life that I live now. I'm so happy and even placid, really, really am placid.
How I feel, I've now got back the man that I married in 1969. He disappeared for a long time, but now I've got him back, and it's lovely. We've got a really good life, we're happy, and it's just unbelievable, really, how God has changed my little husband. With Cap, because of our financial difficulties, I made lots and lots of phone calls. Nobody was willing to help because I was made bankrupt through the business. And then Steve phoned me one day to say that he'd heard about Christians Against Poverty on Radio 1, and to look through the phone book and see if I could find a number. Mm-hmm. And as you know, I got the number for the Staple Hill CAP Centre, rang them and made an appointment, and we haven't looked back since.
No.
They took a lot of weight from my shoulders, because I felt that I had to carry Steve, which I've done for a long, long time, especially when our son died. And I felt that I hadn't had time to grieve because I was looking after Steve. But then with Cap, it was amazing. Mm-hmm. There was no judgment. They just took us on as we were. And as Steve said, we haven't looked back since. Oh. And they've been absolutely fantastic. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. When we were at Ammerdown for the 4 days, I went to the forgiveness class because I've never forgiven our son for dying. But by the end of the evening, all that was gone. I'd forgiven him. And I felt empty, but it was a nice empty. It was wonderful. But as one of the ladies said to me, one of the CAP members, you don't need to go to church to be a Christian. You go to church to learn about Jesus and God. She said, but what you've been through, she said, I think at the moment is enough. And I did say that when I'm ready, I will go to church. I I've been a couple of times, but at the moment it's not for me. But I still have a little faith, and hopefully it will grow. Now that you're settled, I feel in a way that I'm not needed, because I've had to support you through the years and carry you, and that's all gone now. And I think the burden of the forgiveness for our son, that's gone as well. Because the forgiveness class, I thought you'd be in there.
No, I went to the anger management.
Did you? Didn't work.